Okay, we're going to make a pair of hoop earrings from scratch. So this is how I do it. Pretty simple. We have 18 gauge wire here and we have 24 gauge wire here. I also have a old medicine bottle to wrap around to make my size. We got two split rings that we're going to use. We got two fish hook ear wires. We have 4 millimeter pretty blue rondo beads. Let's take some of them out. Let's lay them down. Don't know how many I'm going to need, but we'll start with that. You're going to need a pair of round hole pliers, some cutting wire tool, and I have needle nose that will curve in the end so you don't get any snags. So I'm going to lay these all over here. And I like to start by wrapping it around like this. And then we're going to go around it again. So I wrapped around it. And we're going to wrap it around again until we meet right there. I'll come a little more. Okay. I'm not going to stretch this wire in any way. I'm just going to let it do that. Let it relax just like that. Okay. I'm going to take that out. I'm going to take my wire cutters. I'm going to put it right up against that wire without moving it around or anything. And I'm going to cut. They should split, and of course they didn't. I'm gonna head backwards maybe. Let me go ahead and break this one. Okay, so as you can see, it looks just like this. Go ahead and cut them apart. There you go. Now you got two rings. These are pretty good size for a pair of hoop earrings. Go ahead and lay them back on there, and if your wire got distorted somehow, go ahead and put it back on there. Lay it down. Straighten this one up. The reason why I'm pulling it apart like that, because we are going to wrap the ends. So you see you have a little bit of both, some extra there. So you're going to go on the end here, close to the end as you can get. I'll move this one this way. Going to go to the end here, and I like the very tip. Okay, you're going to roll backwards until it curls up, till you meet right there. Okay, you're going to turn her around and do the same thing to this side. We're going to roll away from us this time. Okay, and it looks just like that. because we're going to put it together like that and it's going to hook. So go back, make sure that's the way it's going to look, just like that. Okay, let's go ahead and do this one. Get to the end, roll away from us until it meets the other side, just like that. This one, roll towards me. And there you go. You have an ear wire. I'm gonna make sure it still fits. I'm sure it does. Straighten it up. There you go. Okay. There. Now we are going to take our 24 gauge wire. Let me find the end, and I am going to cut off about 2, maybe 3 foot. Let's do 3 foot. We probably don't need that much, but better to have too much than not enough and have to redo it all over again. So I'm going to just do stretch this out a little bit. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to take, just lay it like that, and we're going to wrap it around about 3 times. 1, 2, 3. We can do 4. Let's just do 5. Make it pretty. Okay. Now we're going to push it all together. And I like using my finger now. Okay. Okay. Now we're going to pick up, I don't know, I think about 15. Let's do 15. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. If you don't feel like wrapping a bunch of them on there at one time, just go ahead and do a few. Okay, I am going to push this all the way up. And we're going to hold that down like that, and we're going to wrap these beads on there like that. The first couple ones are a little fiddly, but you'll get it. So let's do wrap that like that, and let's do another wrap. Okay. So we're going to put one bead and then 2 wraps. So here you go. I'm going to put a little kink in the end so that it won't come off. There. All right. So now we're going to lay that one like that. Like I said, the first couple ones are a little fiddly. So here we're going to lay that like that. We're going to hold it with our hand. And we're going to wrap it twice. 1, 2. You can squish it together there. Put this one, bring it down. Wrap it once. Wrap it twice. Okay. Let's pull another one down. As beads go everywhere, yes, that is one thing about wire wrapping that you will. So here we go. Go bring that down like that. Hold it with your fingers and wrap it twice. One, two. Bring it down. Give it a little squish. Okay. Here we go again. Lay it on top. Hold it. Wrap once. And wrap twice. Like I said, you can play with your spacing on what, how far apart you want. Okay. I'm going to finish loading up my beads and I'm going to put them on there and I'll be right back. Okay, we're down here on the last one. And I did 5 wraps there. I'm going to do 5 wraps here. So there's 1, 2, 3, give it a little squish over, 4, and 5. There you go. Push them all together. Now, as you can see, some of them are squished away, so all you have to do is just put your fingernail down there and give it a little push. Straighten them up. Okay, let's cut this off. Cut that off, and we're going to use our needle nose pliers because I want to wrap that around so it's not going to poke anybody or poke anything. So you just keep wrapping. So you might end up doing 6 rings, but as long as you turn it, feel to see if there's anything that will catch anybody or catch on. You don't want it to scratch anybody. So there you go. Cut some of that off there. Okay. And turn it around so it doesn't. All you have to do is just lay it like that and just roll it. Roll it around. All right, so there's 1 earring. So all you're going to do is, let's see if it'll go back on there, stretch it back out. You don't have to, but. Okay. Now we're going to take our jump ring. We're going to open it up. I'd rather use these. Open it up. We're going to insert it through that one. Put it through that one. And we're going to close it up. Okay. Nope. That's not closed. There. Now it's closed. We're I'm going to take the other jump ring, open it up, we're going to go inside this one. Now maybe I can do something. We're going to go inside this one. And we're going to put that on there like that. Now we're going to close this up. And you have a Friday night earring. There you go. You have a hoop earring. All right, I'm going to do that again. So we're going to do it again. Let's take about that much. Remember, it's better to have too much than not enough. Okay. Do a round over here. I put like a half inch. Push them together. You can use pliers. I'm going to go ahead and squeeze this one around so that it won't catch on anything. I'll show you what it looks like. Okay. Push it together. And we're going to move it all the way up here. Now we're going to load our beads. One, I put 20 on that one, so I'm gonna put load 20 on this one. Okay, I'm gonna load these up and I'll be right back. All right, we're on the second one. I put the first one like that. You're gonna hold it with your index finger and your thumb. Just lay it on there like that and hold it. You're going to wrap it twice. That's not the one, so we're going to wrap once, twice. Bring this one down. Get it right up close to it. Now you're going to hold these two as you wrap it twice, once, twice. Bring the next one down, lay it right up next to that one, bring it around once and twice, drop the next one, once, twice. Once you get a couple on there, it gets really easy to do because all you're doing is holding the last bead and the front bead and wrap around twice. Sometimes you have to fix that wire. Once you've done a couple of these, it gets repetitive and it gets much easier. So lay that next to that, and once and twice, scooch it up there, drop another bead, lay it up there, once and twice. Yes, it does get fiddly, so if you're a nervous person, this project isn't for you. But it beats paying $15, $20 for a pair of earrings when you can do it yourself, right? See how that one got a little wonky? It's okay. You can pull it back into place. You can move any of them back in place. One, two. Four more to go. Looks like I'm going to need some room, so I have to move these over a little bit. Just by pulling it, it should pull them. So I got three left. Let's see if I can get them on there. One, two. One, two. This is the last one. So it's one and two, three, four, and five. So there you go. Some places the beads are a little further away, so you can straighten them up. All right, so we're gonna take that off of there as close as you can. I need new pliers, sorry guys. We're gonna take our needle nose. Go ahead and fold it as much as we can. Check to see if there's anything sticking out. I don't feel anything. I put it back on my pill bottle. They line up. You can see they line up like that. And okay, I also wanted to show you another way. If you didn't have a lot of jump rings, you can make your own, or you can do this too. I am going to push this a little further up that way. You can take this, bend it like that. Take this one, bend it straight up. Straighten them up. Okay. So this one looks like the... Okay. So we're going to make them look... We're going to put them together like that. So if I only had one more... split ring, if that's all I had, you can do this. Open it up. Always twist this way. Never open it up like that. You can put that in there like this. Go ahead and put your ear wire on. This is all preference. I do this when I'm running out of my split rings. And we're going to close it up. We close it the same way we open until you hear that little grind. Okay, you know it's in the center. Okay. And there you go. You can have it that way. You can squeeze it if you want to. Either way, they are gorgeous. So here is your Friday night earrings. You can make a pair in about 15 minutes. No, stay on there. Ugh. Wow. There you go. Friday night earrings. Thank you for watching. Thank you, BBCraft.com, for supplying the beads to make these earrings. You can get all the supplies listed at BBCraft.com. Thank you for watching.